Hello, my name is Keshwani.
That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani.
We are here because we want to prepare for the GRE. We have been solving GRE math problems out of this book here, the official guide to the revised GRE, the second edition. If you do not own this book already, purchase one immediately. You're going to need it. Today we'll solve a problem having to do with standard deviation. This problem that you see on the blackboard is very similar to the one that you will find on page number 298, number 16, which we have already solved, and the one that you will find on page number 149, number 13. These figures that you see are from number 13 on page 159. Here's what we are told. We are told that 900 students took an exam. 900 students took the exam. We are told that the average score on the exam was 8 points. We are told that the standard deviation was 2.5. Question is, if Michael scored 13 points, approximately how many people scored above him? Very simple, very straightforward problem. If we understand that the distribution, it's a normal distribution, we are told. Normal distribution, as we know, there is your mean, and the mean, we are told, is 8 points. We are further told that the standard deviation is 2.5. Let's look at the standard deviation. Here is the first standard deviation on left, right hand side. Here is another standard deviation on left hand side. And we know 68% of the people, 68% of people are going to score within this range. So if this is 8 and the standard deviation is 2.5, this is going to be 10.5 and this is going to be 6.5. Or is it 7.5? It's 6.5. 8 minus 2 would have been 6, it's going to be 5.5, not 6.5. 8 minus 2 would have been 6, and we need to subtract another half, so it's 5.5. He scored 13 points, so he's not in this range. We have to go one more standard deviation. If we go one more standard deviation here, then another 2.5, this is the first standard deviation, this is another standard deviation. 10.5 and 2.5 is indeed 13. He scored right here. It's a very simple problem, because how many people fall in this tail? We know how many people fall in this tail. In this tail, only two percent of the people are going to score. Only two percent of people are going to score above 13, given the fact that the average was 8 and the standard deviation is 2.5. Let's make a note of it. So what we just learned is that 13 point, which is his score, what we learned is that 13 point is 5 point above the average, which in turn implies that 13 is 2 standard deviation above the mean. We are repeating everything that we have just talked about it, and we know that only 2% scores above 2 standard deviation from the mean. Only 2%, which in turn implies that only 18 people, which represents the 2% of 900. 1% of 900 is 9, 2% is going to be 18. Only 18 people scored above Mike. But we didn't have to make a fuss about it. We didn't have to make all that fuss about it. As soon as we look at this 13 here, we know only 2% are going to fall above that. 2% of 900 is 18. It's very simple. It should take no more than 2 seconds. Let's do the next problem, shall we? In the next problem, we are being asked how many people scored within one standard deviation of the mean. How many people scored within one standard deviation of the mean? Let's erase all this thing. Well, we know that one standard deviation captures approximately two-thirds of the population.
population. Two-thirds of 900 is 600. There you go.
Approximately 600 people are going to score in this 480. Or another way we could have done is that one standard deviation is from here to here. This point represents, this is our mean. This point represents the mean minus the standard deviation, and this point represents the mean plus the standard deviation. We're talking about this range here. And that captures 68% of the population. So if you wanted to be a little bit more precise, still it will not give you the exact number because these are all approximate figures. But if you want to be a little more precise, we could have done 68 times 9, because 900 is what we have here. We could have done that, and you will see that you will get, obviously, 600, because we are saying one standard deviation captures approximately two-thirds of the population, and two-thirds of the population is 66.67%, which is very close to 68. But this is another way we could have done it. 8 nines are 72, 2, carry 7. 6 nines are 54, 54 plus 7 is 661. As you can see, 610 or 612 is the same thing. The difference here is that this is 66.67%, this is exactly 68%. So that's the answer, is about 600. And this might show up as a multiple choice questions. And the answer choices, well, actually, when it did show up as a multiple choice questions, the answers were, I should have given you the answers, it's too late right now. The answers were like this: A, B, C, D, E. And the question was, approximately how many? It should say approximately. Approximately how many people scored within one standard deviation? And the answer choices were 600, 650, 700, 750, and 800. Of course, it's a bit too late in the game because we already know the answer. Answer is 600 or 612. The answer is A. Again, there is not much to do here. You don't even have to plot this graph, bell curve here. You just have to understand that one standard deviation in the normal distribution always captures about two-thirds of the population. But two-thirds of 900 is 600. There's nothing to do there. Nothing at all. Let's do one more, shall we? Part C. A score of 10 is how many standard deviation above or below the mean. A score of 10 is how many standard deviation above or below the mean. Obviously, mean we are told is 8. This guy scored 10, obviously is above the mean. Question is that score of 10, he is 2 points above the mean. 2 points translates into how many standard deviation? Let's find out, shall we? Very simple. His score is 10. His score is 10. The class average is 8. As you said, he scored 2 points above the mean, and the standard deviation is 2.5. So it's 2 over 2.5. Multiply top and bottom by 4. If you were to do that, you'll end up with 8 over 10 or 0.8. Another way we could have figured out is that when we had 2 over 2.5, if you were to multiply top and bottom by 10, we would have gotten 20 over 25, and you reduce it, we get 4/5. And of course, 4/5 is 0.8. So he scored 0.8 standard deviation above the mean. The score of 10 is 0.8 standard deviation above the mean. And if it happens to be multiple choice answers, make sure you pay attention to the words above or below. One might say 0.8 standard deviation above the mean, one might say 1.8 standard deviation below the mean. This guy is above the mean because his score is 10, average is only 8. Obviously, he's above the average. Let's do part D. If one student is chosen at random, what are the odds
what are the odds that his score is going to be between 5.5 and 13.
If one student is chosen at random, what are the odds?
And in the exam, they're not going to say what are the odds. In the exam, they're not going to say what are the odds. They're going to say what is the probability. But it's the same thing. And if you want to write in terms of symbols, this is what we're looking for. We're looking for the probability. P stands for probability. Or what are the odds? What's the probability that it lies between 5.5 and 13? So it has to lie between 5.5 and 13. If
X represents the score of a student who was chosen at random. If you choose one student at random out of 900, his score is represented by letter X. What are the odds that that X, his score, lies between 5.5 and 13? Well, it's right here. Where is 5.5? 5.5 is right there. 5.5 is right there. Let's finish it up, shall we? And 13 is right here. Well, so from 5.5 to 10.5, from 5.5 to 10.5 is 68%, and this is under 14%. And again, you have to know these figures. You have to know your bell curve. 68% and 14% is what we're looking for. So the answer here is, the odds are 68%. 68% is the chance that the score chosen at random is going to fall between 5.5 and 10.5. We don't want to stop at 10.5, we want to go up to 13, all the way up to 13. And between 10.5 and 13, another 14% of the population is going to fall. So 68 plus 14. It's 82% likely, very likely in fact, 8 out of 10 times, more than 8 out of 10 times, there is an 82% chance that if you were to pick one score at random, if you were to pick one student at random, that his score is going to fall within 5.5 and 13, because that's a big range there, given the fact that the standard deviation is only 2.5. Let's do one last one. This was part D. Let's do part E. I don't know why it says 4, it should have said D. Part E. Approximately, how many students, approximately how many students scored between 5.5 and 13? As we can clearly see, that this question is similar to what we just finished. Approximately how many students scored between 5.5 and 13? We have to first figure out what that is in percentage. Between 5.5 and 13, we just figured out, is 82%. We just have to figure out. So the question here is, we just have to figure out, the question here is, 82% of 900 is what? What is 82% of 900? Let's find out, shall we? Didn't we do that here? No, that was 68%. We need 82%. So let's do it out. So let's do it right here. 82% of 900. 82 times 9. 18. Carry 1. 72 plus 173. There we go. The answer is about 738 students are going to fall between 5.5 and 13. And the same answer choices probably would have served again. If 738, the one that comes closest to 750. That was it. I'll see you tomorrow, okay? Bye now.